Hey everyone, I'm Anne-Marie from Hello Basque. Welcome to the Hello Basque YouTube channel. If you're new here, I'm posting videos every week all about the Basque Country, and I speak English because I'm American, but my dad's from the Basque Country. This video is part of a series of videos about the different Basque provinces of the Basque Country. Today's video is all about the province of Araba. Now, we're almost, we've got one more until the end, so we're getting close. I saved Araba towards the end because, to be honest with you, personally, I haven't spent very much time there, and I don't know too much about it, so I actually did a little bit of research before this video. If you've been following the channel, like, my relationship to research is sometimes very intense and sometimes very lax. Oh, and here's the cat. I usually lock him out of the rooms when I'm recording videos, but he was just sleeping in the corner, and I thought it would be fine, but okay, we have a visitor. Okay. So the province of Araba, the main thing I know about it is its capital city, Vitoria-Gasteiz. And that's the only place in the province that I've been to. I've been to Vitoria-Gasteiz a few times. And the main thing that I know about it really is that it is the seat of the government of the Basque Autonomous Community. I've done a few videos on this topic, but pretty much the Basque Country is divided into different kind of political governing bodies, and one of them, the most famous of them, is the Basque Autonomous Community within Spain, also known as Euskadi. And that's made up of three Basque provinces, Bizkaia, Gipuzkoa, and Araba. Now, Bizkaia, Gipuzkoa are maybe the better known ones because they have larger cities that have more tourism, but Vitoria-Gasteiz is a very cool city that I'm sad a lot of people overlook when they go to the Basque Country because it is beautiful. It was like the green capital of Europe a few years ago, so it's very green. It has tons of parks, tons of trees. It's beautiful architecture. The government buildings are really impressive. The main square is beautiful. And pretty much, I would like to go back and spend more time there, honestly, but it's kind of out of the way for me whenever I go to the Basque Country. I usually go visit my family, which is in Iparralde, the northern Basque Country, French Basque Country, and so the province of Araba is kind of like all the way on the other end of the Basque Country, which is a small place, but it can easily suck you into whatever corner you're in. So Araba, to me, like, conceptually is an interesting place because, like, in theory, it's, like, the most Basque of all the places because it's the seat of the Basque government. But at the same time, from what I've read, there's actually, of the provinces, there's not that many people who actually speak Euskera, the Basque language. There are, but they tend to be younger, people who learned the language in school rather than at home in their families. And in terms of tourism in Araba, the major thing is La Rioja. It's a huge wine producing region. If you're not familiar, kind of famous. But La Rioja is also its own community within Spain, outside of Araba. But as a region, it kind of spills over into Araba. So a lot of people think of La Rioja as its own thing, which it is. But also they specify it. It's called La Rioja Alavesa, the Alaviz Rioja, I don't know how that translates, but basically the Rioja region within Araba. And so they also do make some very good wine out there. I've seen the pictures on Instagram, the wineries look really beautiful. When you look at Araba on a map, if you look at Euskadi on a map, I always found it really interesting because, like, there's kind of like a hole within the province of Araba. There's like a chunk that's usually grayed out. If you're looking at a map of the Basque Country, like more of a Basque map, Basque-centered map, it's complete. But if you look at more of like a Spanish map of Araba and Euskadi, there's a hole out of this one section of Araba. And so I was doing some research. That's an enclave, they call, called Treviño. And pretty much, even though it's like technically in the middle of the province of Araba, like in terms of government, it's part of the jurisdiction of the province of Burgos, which is part of Castile and León, which is a different community within Spain. And so it's not actually governed by the province of Araba. And I was trying to do some research. If you go to the Wikipedia page in English, like, there's not a lot of information. So I didn't dig too deep into it, but basically it's like historically that this one section of the area was more aligned with Castile than the rest of Araba. And so with that, over the years, like, it just so happens that this one section is governed by a different region. And from what I've read a little bit, it's kind of controversial because since it's such a small area, a lot of the people who live in Treviño actually have their services, like they go to their doctors and dentists and school or whatever, maybe not school, but they go to the capital of Araba, Vitoria-Gasteiz, for a lot of social services, even though they pay taxes to Burgos, Spain, rather than the Basque Autonomous Community that these services are funded by in Vitoria-Gasteiz. If that makes any sense, I don't know. As an American, it's kind of a little complicated, but I just thought it was interesting to mention that Araba, like, conceptually is the Basque place in the Basque country because it's the seat of the Basque government, but there's also one section of it that's, like, totally not associated with the Basque government. Anyway, I thought it was interesting, and I hope you did too. If you want to school me on Araba, honestly, I'm very happy to read your comments because from what I've seen on Instagram, it looks like a really beautiful place. I just haven't explored too much the countryside and what it has to offer. So please let me know in the comments what you want to share about Araba. Thank you so much for watching. We only have one more video in this series left to go. That's on the province of Nafarroa, which should be coming out next Thursday. If you want to subscribe to the Hella Basque YouTube channel and check back in with that. And I also have linked in the description of this video the other videos that I made on this topic, so you can go learn about the other provinces of the Basque country if you're just interested in learning a little more about, like, the regions of this very small regional part of the world. So thank you so much for watching. Also, if you want to keep in touch with me in between times, you can follow Hella Basque on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Hella Basque. So I hope to see you in the next video. Bye. Sorry about the cat. He's got kind of a bad eye from birth. And he was sitting in the shelter for 6 months because nobody wanted him because he was ugly. And that made me love him even more.